What only exists to fuck with us? The ads that have X inside the ad, so that when you click and close it, it takes you to the link site. Even when the X is real, they make it ridiculously small so you miss half the time. Getting super itchy for no apparent reason. I'll add to this. When you have a random phantom type itch that you can't quite find. Edit, what the fuck? I can't even leave you guys for an hour without something dumb exploding. Haha, thanks everyone. Bed bugs. The fact that you have to burn your house down to get rid of the fuckers, and sometimes that still doesn't work, just shows the cosmos just wants to fuck with us and slowly drive us mad. Hotel maintenance here. You have great advice, but I have to add, getting rid of any wood furniture, a bed frame, nightstands, TV stands, etc., they eat that shit. Switch to metal. A very good exterminator could have probably ended the infestation, but that's thousands and repeat visits. My boss pays for that though, and I haven't brought any home in 3 years. Oh, and on that topic, 99.99% of every single hotel you stay in has bed bugs at some point. Good luck, everyone. That last drop of pee. Me. All right, Mr. Penis. I pushed out all that urine and even shook you to get any sneaky droplets out. We good, penis? For sure, bruh. I'm ready to pack it in. Me, unzips pants. Penis, nah, I'm just fucking with you. Ah, let me dribble up in here. Fuck your boxer shorts. The unlock, lock, unlock routine we do on car doors when someone pulls the handle and unlocks at the same time. Oh my god, that drives me insane. I really love it when people start furiously yanking on my car handle. Like, if they can just pull it hard enough, it'll magically open. I've gotten to the point where I just tell people to keep their hands off the door until I give them the okay. Stop molesting my car, dammit. I dated a girl who would let me do that all the time, and I always told her that she could screw up the handle, and she never believed me. Lo and behold, one winter, she tried yanking on her door, and ripped the whole handle straight off. Edit. Since people are wondering, it was a Kia Sportage. You reminded me of a time when my stepdad, a carpet and upholstery cleaner by trade, offered to detail the inside of my car as a gift. I told it I would unlock it for him via the car's remote. He proceeded to assault the car door handle for 30 seconds before I even got the remote out of my pocket. I had to yell at him to stop because he was going to set off the alarm. He just looked so confused by the whole matter. I just don't get what's so hard about waiting until you hear the various obvious ka-chunk unlocking sound before you start yanking on the door handle. Mosquitoes or flies? Take your pick. Flies are annoying, but pretty important for our ecosystem. They pollinate a lot of plants. Mosquitoes, on the other hand, can go fuck themselves. I'm sure they play some role in our ecosystem, but everyone would be happy to go the extra mile and replace their function for the sake of all bleeding beings on this planet. Extremely low drop chances on a rarely spawning enemy. Wither skeleton skull. I'd say tridents. 6% of drowns spawn with one and only have an 8% chance of dropping. Wither skeletons themselves are actually sort of common. Our brains, because when others are whispering, our brains automatically think they are talking about us and cause some of us to be anxious and quiet all the time. This comment is about me. Here's me thinking, he probably implanted a tracking device in me through the 5G network. I need to escape to Iceland where the northern lights can scramble the signal. Our US system of taxation, not the taxation itself, but literally the system. It would be easy for the IRS to calculate our taxes for us, but thanks to lobbying and interference by TurboTax, they don't. Nothing infuriates me more. There's no reason we couldn't be square with the IRS daily, and April, simply a formality. Hell, I could probably automate it, and I could barely math.
IRS? Sorry, we can't automate this. Not enough computing power on the planet, or something.
The bureaucracy and the inefficiency of the US government system astonishes me, even as a foreign citizen doing business. I'm so used to countries in the Anglosphere having very slick online systems with great UX, and then the US, which should be the leader, feels like stepping back 20 years. Wasps, ticks, fleas, bedbugs, gnats, and most politicians. Edit. Some people said I forgot a few, so here are some more they said. Stink bugs, mosquitoes, yellow jackets, mosquitoes, 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 cops, scabbies, mosquitoes, mosquitoes, cockroaches, mosquitoes, lice, mosquitoes, lice, mosquitoes, shadflies, midges, mosquitoes, bark scorpions, mosquitoes, disease, the Rona, mosquitoes, horseflies, and last of all, mosquitoes. I'm a firm believer that every creature has a purpose in the ecosystem, except bedbugs. If I could instantly commit bedbug genocide or breed a special government-issue sleep companion possum that only ate them, I would. I'm literally dealing with an infestation right now. It's a nightmare of itchiness and not knowing if they're gone after treatment. These fuckers can apparently last up to 18 months without eating, and one female can lay 3,000 eggs. The Riddler side missions and the Batman Arkham games. I never did more than that one where you look at the painting of the guy in the suit. That was it. I more or less swore it off after Arkham Asylum. Then Arkham Knight comes along and decides to not give us the end unless we finished all of the side missions. That was the point where I died inside. Water, we need it to survive or we'll dehydrate. If we swim in it and drown, we'll suffocate. It falls from the sky, lightly, like snow making it harder to see and walk, or like hail, where it's raining death sentence. Not to mention, you can't go without it for more than 3 days, and if you drink too much, you die. Geese are fucked up. I saw and was an accessory to a goose murder once. There's this one road near me, notorious for geese hanging out there during spring and summer. They basically own the roads, so if they are in the streets, we stop for them until they get the fuck out. We can also get in trouble for running them over because they are game animals or something. Not that I'm the type to willingly run over an animal. Just giving context for why we don't pretend to move up on them in our cars to scare them off when they block the road. If we accidentally hit the gas too hard and hit them or they call our bluff or something, we can get in trouble. So I'm driving down the street and there's a group of geese chilling on the sidewalk. I slow down ever so slightly in case they decide to cross the road, and one that was farther away flies over to that group, towards one in particular, and intimidates his opposed goose into the road just in time for me to hit it. The timing was, I refuse to believe that that wasn't planned. Its goal was to push that goose into the path of my car. That goose was homicide, and I was the weapon. Cats. Cats were put on this earth to fuck with us. Cat comes up to rub all over you and purring away. Then attacks your hand, puts something on the table, cat jumps up and knocks it on the floor. Crawling into bed half asleep in the middle of the night, cat attacks your feet from under the bed. Walking through the house, minding your own business, cat darts down the hallway and trips you. If they like you, they bring you dead things inside as gifts. If they want to fuck with you, they bring you alive things and let them go in front of you, and you don't bother to catch them again. They sit and laugh at you while you try to catch the squirrel climbing all over your house. Telemarketers. I have a really special copypasta based off the Navy SEAL copypasta for me to recite whenever I get telemarketers. I answer in Esperanto. I keep talking until they hang up. Then they call again, but in Spanish. Then they call again in some other language I don't recognize. Then they stop calling. I've done this to the past 7 telescammers and have gradually stopped getting calls. Almost nobody knows Esperanto, and that's a strength when it comes to phone calls. Our brains? Shit just decides it's a great day to have a breakdown for no apparent reason. For me, it's opposite. I'll go through a day and just feel great and be thinking, but why? How do I recreate this? And I always fail to. I have days like that. Last Friday, I was singing in the car, cracking jokes, and just having a gay old time. It's bittersweet because I know it's just temporary, and I can't just choose to feel great 24/7. I think the best way to maximize these feelings is through lifestyle choices. Sleep, diet, and exercise. Not that it's a secret happy cure, but for me anyway, I tend to have more good days, and my shitty days are more tolerable. An appendix. Don't share if you're being serious. But new research suggests that the appendix may actually have some functions other than getting appendicitis and wasting your money on surgery. Yeah, it's thought to be a reserve for certain kinds of good bacteria in the gut. I think people who have their appendix experience less gastrointestinal problems after taking broad-spectrum antibiotics. Pollen. Our bodies are pretty amazing things. We can have conscious thoughts. We can build machines that fly us in the air. Our immune systems deal with some crazy shit every day, and most of it, we pay no mind. And then comes grass pollen, destroying your life. Tax returns, as they are currently handled, The government already has all your information in terms of income, dependents, property, employment, etc. Major purchases and sales, homes, cars, etc., usually need to be registered anyways. So they should have that too. There is really no reason why the government shouldn't already know how much you make and own. And what are you eligible for? The only information you really need to declare to them are expenses that can lead to tax deductions, rent, charitable donations, tuition in some cases, etc. There is very little reason why taxes shouldn't just be the government mailing you a summary based on what you already have, and why you sending in receipts to prove what info they don't have. Daylight savings time. Dear God, why is this still a thing? All it does is fuck with us. It gives us zero benefits, and it's just a pain in the ass. And the best part is it isn't even nature or reality forcing this on us. No, we force it on ourselves, like some sort of societal-level masochism. Australian wildlife. Oh, you thought that was big and bad? Terraforming the land to build your cities? Well, guess what? You in my house now. You get the coast, and I'll let you build inland. A bit. But for every mile you take, I will take a gallon of blood, and I'll keep a few secret pets, just so when you think you've seen all my tricks, wham! Sudden Elijah with a snake's head. Yeah, you've never seen it, but you never know what I've got hidden in the outback.
Cigarettes. It literally has no benefits, only negatives. And they add nicotine, so that you feel worse without it, so that you stay hooked. Vestigiality. During the process of evolution, this is when a species retains a physical structure or attribute that has lost some or all of their ancestral function. A common example is humans in the appendix. Another well-known example is flightless birds who still have wings, ostriches and emus, among others. In terms of the question, imagine being a bird with wings that don't work. Talk about being fucked with. Same goes for the human appendix. As far as science understands, it does nothing. Yet, 10 million people per year are diagnosed with appendicitis and have undergoing surgery to remove it. Cicadas, they are so noisy, and when you get close enough to find where they are, they either stop or another cicada near starts making noise. ATM fees, especially from other banks. Circumcision, since ancient Greece, it has been practiced as the means to detuning sexuality. The earliest advocates stated that it would improve the purity of the soul by diminishing the enjoyment of oral sex. Much later, it was popularized in the US by Dr. Kellogg as an anti-masturbatory practice. Somehow, this barbaric practice still exists. It's unnecessary cosmetic mutilation, and it needs to end.